Welcome back, everybody, to another night of astrophotography here on the Astro Pilot YouTube channel. Tonight, we are imaging the Whirlpool galaxy. I have to go to work again, and I won't be back until around 11 o'clock, so perfect time for all the primary targets for galaxy season and pop out. So join me in this night of astrophotography as we image the Whirlpool galaxy. My name's Trevor, and you're watching Astro Pilot. So a little info on the target tonight. The Whirlpool galaxy, Messier 51, is a spiral galaxy located 23 million light years away. But the special thing about this target is it's actually two colliding galaxies interacting with each other. So there's a smaller galaxy to the left of the main Whirlpool galaxy, and they're interacting with each other. So they are merging, so this is a galactic merger event that we're seeing as we take this picture. It's 23 million light years away, so it's a long way away. We're seeing this image as it was 23 million years ago, so yeah, really awesome target, so I can't wait to start imaging it. So the gear I'm using tonight is, as usual, the William Optic Zenith Star 61 with my modified Canon XSI with the IDIS LPS D2 light pollution filter. Also the ZWO ASI 120mm mini guide camera with the QHY mini guide scope. I also have a red dot finder attached to the side of it there as well. And this is all sitting on top of the Skywatcher Star Adventurer. And as well, we have the super heavy duty Skywatcher stainless steel tripod that is super rugged and solid. So this is the setup for tonight. I'm controlling it all from my Panasonic Toughbook in that plastic container over there, using APT and PHD2 guiding. So a lot of people might think the Zenith Star 61 is a little small for distant galaxies like this, but it's actually not at all. The native focal length is 360 millimeters, but with a crop sensor DSLR, that turns it into a 576 millimeters. So almost a 600 millimeter focal length telescope with a DSLR. So that's a very versatile focal length. It allows for wide field nebulae targets or deep, really deep sky distant galaxies like the Whirlpool galaxy. So overall, it's a very versatile setup. So small refractor like this is definitely the way to go if you're starting out. So a lot of people have been asking how I find my targets with the Star Adventurer, because as you know, it's a full manual mount. You have to find everything yourself, point and shoot style mount. At times, depending on the target you're shooting, it can be very, very difficult, to the point where you just want to give up. But the things I found to make it better is a red dot finder. That helps a lot just to get you in the general area, because with the guide scope, it's sort of hard to aim at anything. And then also I use the program Stellarium to put my camera frame in the program to know what field of view I'm gonna have. So there's a process called star hopping, which you go from like a region where you know where you're at in the sky, and you see that star through the viewfinder of the camera. You know you're in the general area of your target. Then you look at stellarium and see what if there's a bright star that's gonna be in your frame, and you just hop your way over. Usually, say I have a star in the frame that I know it's near the target, so okay, I'm gonna move that star over there, and then okay, I see the star that's supposed to be in the frame, and then I lock it down and start taking test shots to see where I'm at. And then you might get the target in your frame, and then you can start framing it up by twisting the declination knob or using the slew buttons here to go up and down, left and right. So overall, it's not bad. It just depends on the target you're shooting. Usually in the summertime and even in Orion and everything, it just depends on the target. So for large nebula targets or the Andromeda Galaxy, they're really easy to frame up. You can just point at the red dot finder and just see it through the viewfinder because they're really bright targets. But for small distant galaxies like the Whirlpool Galaxy or the Pinwheel Galaxy or the Needle Galaxy, something like that, they can be more difficult. But just research some on the topic of star hopping and just finding targets with the Star Adventure. It's not bad. I've heard people do plate solving, so I might look into that. It tells you the coordinates to go to with the right ascension and declination, so that might be a help. I might try that in the future. But overall, it's not a bad way to find targets. Just depends drastically on the type of target you're shooting. But overall, most of the time I get it framed up pretty quickly. Sometimes it can be difficult, but not bad. So there's a little tip on that. Another great thing to do if you're shooting with a DSLR like I am is get a AC power adapter for your DSLR. It's like a false battery, and it has a cord and it has a wall plug, and you have unlimited power. For your DSLR, you can shoot all night without having to worry about a dead battery. So you can get this for about $20 or so off Amazon or something like that. So well worth the money, because you don't have to worry about your camera dying. So right now we're gonna focus the camera. We have the Batinov mask on. I have the telescope lined up on the bright star Sirius, and now we're gonna focus. So we have the star in the frame. We'll just line it up and zoom all the way in. Got those diffraction spikes. We want those to be perfectly centered. Right about there. And right there is perfect. So it's very easy to focus the camera with a Batinov mask. Make sure you just got those spikes lined up and you are all set. So everybody, it is about 11:30 now and I have my target all framed up. I am shooting the Whirlpool Galaxy. It's a very, very awesome target. Two colliding galaxies. Looks like a big Whirlpool. Spiral galaxies, and really awesome target. So I just got framed up and shooting. I'm doing 3-minute subs, ISO 800, and got my guiding going and dithering, so I'll show you that real quick. All is going well so far. So here's a quick little look with my guiding. I'm guiding at 1.4 error. Really good for the Star Adventure. Allows me to get really good 3-minute exposures. And I'll go ahead and switch over to my shots. All right, everybody. So here comes the first 3-minute exposure on the Whirlpool Galaxy in 3, 2, 1. Look at that. That is the Whirlpool galaxy. Millions of light years away, two galaxies colliding, and that's it right there. Right in the center of the frame. Super excited about this picture. Super awesome target. So thank you guys for watching this video. Stay tuned for the final image, and hopefully I can get a good picture out of this. So yeah, I'm gonna hook up to my remote desktop and go inside because it is 20 degrees out here and I'm freezing. So yeah, all is going well, so we'll see how it goes.